God is good today and every day. Isn't it nice? The sunshine?
Beautiful. Yeah.
No rain. Praise the Lord. And everybody's here. Hello, Jose. We missed all you guys the last couple weeks. There are some people that tapped it out. Israel was here last week. And Luis had come. Rosa was here. And they had some good chili dogs. Oh, well. There's a term that you say, you snooze, you lose. So be sure you come so you get some good food. Both carne and espiritu comida. Para su corazón. Si? Y ama. All right? I learned a few words this week. Praise the Lord. I go, ¿qué es alma? Alma. Oh, your soul. Oh boy, thank you, Lord. I needed to know that word. So we just thank you, Lord, for this this day of your coronation. I ask you, Father God, to make us worthy of receiving you on that day you come back, that you don't find us drinking or doing drugs or anything of that sort, Lord, but you see us honoring you and that you will be well pleased with your servants. So we're going to blow this shofar in honor of you and welcome, also welcome the power of the Holy Spirit upon each and every person here to touch their hearts, minds, and souls so that they will receive the good news and know what's expected in eternity. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Jesus.
Amen.
Today, and we're gonna sing along. We are so blessed. Stephanie's gonna be over here singing with us. So, what is our theme, Tima? Or is God's greatest gift, His gift of love, regalo de amor. See?
God so loved the world.
Thank you.
Zacchaeus, he goes by from Posario de la Alto, Pastor Rosario's church. And he's come out to volunteer and to share his love with everybody. And his little doggy, Pedro Copo. And the name is Way For More. It was for love.
Oh!
In English, good, good, Father, bueno, bueno, padre. And después is John 3:16 in Espanol. Gloria a Dios.
Gloria a Dios. Gloria a Dios, aleluya.
Thank you.
mitzvahs the month. So memorize that, okay? Jerry's gonna come back up.
I'm going to do a little pan here for everybody that's here. Que Dios me bendiga.
Ahora
que Dios me bendiga.
Beautiful day, you guys.
So beautiful. Como vemos el pasado, muchos no pudieron estar por la lluvia.
Oh my gosh, I don't think I remember last Sunday, it was raining so hard.
Pero gracias a Dios que este día Él nos ha regalado un día maravilloso.
But we're so thankful that God has given us a beautiful day today.
Y para esta tarde, pues el tema que estamos viendo es el regalo más grande de Dios.
And you guys, we're really excited again because we have a new theme again, and it's God's greatest gift for the month of February, right? How many of you guys remember? Amen.
Amen. Este, el regalo más grande de Dios, y el versículo es Juan 3:16.
And you guys, how many of you guys know the memory verse? John 3:16, so we're going to go right to that, to John 3:16.
Dice la palabra de Dios, la leemos en el nombre del Padre, del Hijo y del Espíritu Santo. Porque de tal manera amó Dios al mundo que ha dado a su Hijo unigénito, para que todo aquel que en Él cree no se pierda, mas tenga vida eterna.
Aleluya. Amén. So we're going to read John 3:16, you guys, and this is one of the most well-known verses in Christianity, right? Larry, you totally know. So if you guys know it, shout it out with me, okay? For God so loved the world that He gave His one and only Son as a gift. Whosoever believeth on Him shall not perish, but receive everlasting eternal life.
Si vemos, este es uno de los versículos más impactantes para nuestras vidas.
This is one of the most impactful and, like she said, truest verses of the gospel,
Este versículo lo podemos encontrar en la casa, en la pared, pegado, en cualquier lugar, porque es uno de los versículos que más se conoce de los que está en la Biblia.
And, you can go anywhere, right, in this world and see John 3:16, in any art, like in a page or a painting, anywhere you go, and you ask anyone in the world, even they know, right? John 3:16, even unbelievers.
Porque en ese versículo nos dice cómo Dios nos ama tanto.
And you know, what is this verse really truly about, the core? God's love for us, right? That's what it's truly about.
Como dice, porque de tal manera amó Dios al mundo.
Because it says very clearly, you guys, it says, this is how much, right? God loved the world. And then He explains how much.
Ese, dice, cuando dice, de tal manera amó Dios al mundo, es que quiere decir que Dios le ama a usted y a mí, porque estamos, pues, en este mundo, Él nos creó para vida eterna.
And the love of God, He's describing His, God's love, right? God's kind of love. How He created us. He created us for eternal life, not for death.
Pero Dios tuvo que hacer un plan de salvación para que nosotros pudiésemos entrar al reino de los cielos.
Yeah, but you guys, this plan that God had, that John 3:16 states, it talks about a specific plan of redemption, a plan of salvation.
Porque dice la palabra de Dios en Romanos 3:23 que todos nosotros estábamos lejos de Dios por el pecado.
And also, similar to John 3:16, Romans 3:23, another very well-known verse says that every single one of us was born away from God, alejado de Dios, in sin, right? In a state of sinfulness.
Dice, por cuanto todos pecaron y están destituidos de la gloria de Dios.
And in Ephesians 2 it also says, well, we were, you guys, completely lost and gone, right? Completely, void of God's mercy. Christ died for us.
Dice, por cuanto todos pecaron, quiere decir que todos nosotros somos pecadores, ¿verdad? Y pero por el pecado que hizo Adán y Eva, desde el principio, nosotros estábamos destituidos de la gloria de Dios y no teníamos entrada al reino de los cielos.
And so, like she's saying, you guys, what happened when Adam and Eve fell? The whole world fell right along with them, including us.
Porque Dios nos había creado para vivir eternamente, pero lastimosamente el pecado vino a separarnos de Dios.
And so God has always, like God is eternal, and in His image we are made. We were created to live eternally. But what happened, guys? Once we fell, we lost that image, that likeness.
Y el precio de nuestros pecados era la muerte.
And the wages of sin, how many of you guys all know this? The wages of sin is death.
Como dice en Romanos 6:23, porque la paga del pecado es muerte.
The wages of our sin is death.
Mas la dádiva de Dios es vida eterna en Cristo Jesús, Señor nuestro.
Amén, gloria a Dios.
But he stopped, but then he says, and this is the solution. But in Christ Jesus, it's possible to have an experience of eternal life.
Amén. Si hay una solución para nosotros poder vivir eternamente con Cristo Jesús.
And this solution, you guys, we're not lost. We have, there's a way, there's a solution, there's an answer.
Como dice, más la dádiva de Dios es vida eterna en Cristo Jesús.
Yes. Just like in Christ Jesus, we receive this gift of eternal life.
Por medio de Jesús, nosotros podemos tener esa vida eterna, right. Ese regalo que Dios nos dio, que es la salvación.
Amén.
This greatest gift God gave us is the salvation in Jesus Christ. What He did for us.
Porque Jesús murió por cada uno de nosotros.
Because Jesus died, you guys, for each and every one of us. Amen? Amen.
Podemos encontrar muchos versículos de la Biblia donde nos habla del gran amor de Dios, porque el gran amor de Dios es infinito, no se termina nunca.
And God's love, just like she so beautifully described, you guys, is, we can't wrap our minds around it. It's infinite, it's eternal, it's glorious, it's amazing.
Dice en Romanos 5:8, mas Dios muestra su amor para con nosotros, que siendo aún pecadores, Cristo murió por nosotros.
And Romans 5:8, you guys, says the same exact thing. Paul is laying this out for us. While we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Amen.
Cristo murió para que ahora nosotros tuviésemos esa salvación y esa vida eterna. Y ya nosotros ya no nos tocaría ir al infierno, sino que Él nos da la oportunidad de que nos vayamos al cielo con Él.
And this amazing gift that He gives us, this eternal life, is our escape plan, right? It's not just our escape plan in this earth, but also in the one to come. We escape hell through the salvation gift of Jesus Christ, eternal condemnation, what we deserve. He gives us eternal life. Amen?
Amen.
Como decía nuestra hermana Mónica el domingo pasado, que el amor de Dios es ágape. Ese amor que nunca se termina.
And like we were saying last Sunday, me and my sister Stephanie, that God's love is agape, pure, undefiled, right? Never ending, unselfish.
Pero también para poder entrar al reino de los cielos, nosotros, tú y yo, tenemos que creer en Jesús.
Hallelujah. But so Jesus made the way, right? But we have to enter in through Him and through that gate, right? Still, in order to receive it, right?
Y tenemos que confesar con nuestra boca que Jesús es el Señor.
And what else, and also because the Bible says the legal transaction has to be made from this realm to the next. We have to confess with your mouth. You choose, you decide. Jesus, you are my Lord, right? Otherwise, it's not valid.
La palabra de Dios dice en Romanos 10:9, que si confesares con tu boca que Jesús es el Señor y creyeres en tu corazón que Dios le levantó de los muertos, serás salvo.
Right, that's right. And in Romans 10:9, and then going through that, it says, if you believe in your heart that Jesus Christ is Lord, and you confess with your mouth that God raised Him from the dead, you shall be saved.
Pero nosotros tenemos que creer en Jesús, porque muchos muchas veces muchos creen en Dios, pero no creen en Jesús.
And so, this is very, very subtle, but you know, most people say, oh, I believe in God, yeah, sure, whatever. But they don't believe Jesus is their Lord and Savior. See the difference?
Y sabemos que Jesús es el mismo Dios, nada más que Él se tuvo que hacerse hombre para poder morir por cada uno de nosotros.
That's right. And just like she's saying, this is a pure gospel message. We know Jesus is God, but He came and He clothed Himself with flesh for us to save humanity. He became like us. Why? To save us. Make sense?
El Padre, el Hijo y el Espíritu Santo es una sola persona.
And we believe in one God, three parts. One only God, un solo Dios, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Si vemos en Juan 1:1 dice que en el principio era el Verbo, y el Verbo era con Dios, y el Verbo era Dios.
Amen. And in John 1, God lays this out through John, and He says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Jesus was God. Pre-existing, He is God now, and He always will be God.
¿Quién es el Verbo? Es Jesús.
Jesus.
Si le cambiamos el verbo, en el principio era Jesús.
And in the beginning, Jesus was.
Y Jesús era con Dios. Y Jesús era Dios.
And so Jesus was God, and He always will be God. What John is trying to say is that Jesus was pre-existent. With the Father, He always was.
Por eso, para poder entrar al reino de los cielos, tenemos que aceptar a Jesús en nuestro corazón.
Yes. So we need to enter in through Jesus by believing in our heart, not with our head, in our heart that Jesus is Lord.
Porque como les decía, Jesús tuvo que ser hombre. Dice en Juan 1:14. Y aquel verbo fue hecho carne y habitó entre nosotros y vimos su gloria, gloria como del unigénito del Padre, lleno de gracia y verdad.
Aleluya. And continuing in John 1, if you go to John 1:14 and going down, it says that the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we saw His glory, right? When on the mountain of transfiguration, they saw the glory of God, His glory, Jesus' glory.
Amen. Dice que aquel verbo fue hecho carne y habitó entre nosotros. Imagínense, Dios habitó entre nosotros y todavía su presencia habita aquellos que le damos lugar.
Amen. And God, to this day, back then, and always will be, habitating, Emmanuel, God with us, right? God among us. If you make room in your heart for Him in your life, He will abide with you, right? He wants to abide with you. He desires to abide with you.
Porque Dios quiere que su gloria se manifieste en nosotros.
That's right. Because God wants to reveal His glory. He does that through His people, His children.
Todo lo que Él desea es que le demos la gloria a Él y la honra.
Right. All He wants is to recognize who and where this all comes from. All the glory always goes to Him. He is the one that is only worthy of the glory and the honor. He, Him, not us, Him. Amen?
Y que todo lo que hagamos, lo hagamos para Él.
Amen. And He wants us to like recognize and understand that, first of all, we can't do anything without Him, right? So if we are able to do anything, we always remember, only You receive the glory, right?
Como por ejemplo, si en tu trabajo te ponen a hacer algo, tú no reniegues, tú hazlo como que lo estás haciendo para Dios.
And this changes our character, right? So, like it says, do all that you do unto the glory of God. Not as if you were working for man, right? So don't get irritated with our bosses when they tell us do something or whatever. We just do it. Why? Because we're not doing it for them, we're doing it for Him. Amen.
Porque la recompensa viene de lo alto, de Dios, no del hombre.
Right. And so everything, we know that our gift and whatever, you know, reward is heaven, it's eternal, it comes from God, not from others, not from man.
Así que siempre que hagas algo, la gloria y la honra que sea para Dios.
Praise God. Yeah. So we always recognize and remember that the glory always goes to God. Always, right? Always.
El amor de Dios es tan maravilloso que Él quiere darte la vida eterna.
And God's love, you guys, for humanity, for His creation, has always been so rich. And His desire is that none should perish and all should be saved.
¿Sabías que la vida eterna puede ser tuya?
No. Did you guys know that if you have not received this gift, today you can receive eternal life?
Dios nos dice en su palabra en Juan 5:24, dice, de cierto os digo, el que oye mi palabra y cree al que me envió, tiene vida eterna.
Aleluya.
Y no vendrá a condenación, mas ha pasado de muerte a vida.
Aleluya. And so also in John 5, he says very clearly, says, whosoever believeth in me will not see death, right? But basically what he's saying, whoever believeth on me has passed over from death to life. I believe that's in John 5. And I know. 5:21. John 5:24, if you guys want to look it up. I know it by memory, but not by the verse. But Jesus clearly says, let me just make sure I said this clearly. Whoever believeth on me shall not see death, but has passed over from death to life.
Dice, el que oye mi palabra, ¿cuánto no hemos escuchado la palabra de Dios?
How many of us have heard God's word, right?
Y dice, y cree al que me envió, tiene vida eterna.
How many of us have you guys believe on him? The one that sent Jesus. Who sent Jesus? Who sent Jesus?
God the Father.
Okay. So that's what Jesus is saying. There you go. Amen.
Tú puedes ser salvo ahora mismo.
And today is the day, you guys, right now. Today is your day of salvation.
Que dicen Juan 1:12, mas a todos los que le recibieron, a los que creen en su nombre, le dio potestad de ser hechos hijos de Dios.
And you guys, in John 1:12, it says very clearly too, going down the whole book of John chapter 1. John 1:12 states this. Whoever had adhered to him and believeth in his teachings and follows him, he has given him the authority or the power, potestad, de ser children of God. Amen?
Amen.
John 1:12.
Imagínense el gran amor de Dios que dice que si nosotros lo recibimos a Jesús en nuestro corazón y creemos en el nombre de Jesús, Él nos ha hecho hijo suyo, dice.
Amen.
Dios es nuestro Padre.
And once we make this exchange, you guys, we become actual blood-bought children of the living God. Children of God. Now, you're not just any random person walking down the street. You're a child of God. And this is very, very important to understand, regardless of your sin. I mean, I'm going to be honest with you guys. We all will make mistakes, but that does not change who you are.
Dios es nuestro Padre, y si Él es nuestro Padre, Él nos librará de todo mal.
That's right. Amen. And the God being our Father, God the Father, wants to and will set us free from all bondage and sin.
No tenemos que temer a nada.
And so we will live fearless. Why? Because God's love will drive that out, right? That's what we want. That's, come on now. That's exactly right.
Porque su amor nunca se aparta de cada uno de nosotros.
And His love abides and is with us and will remain in us and with us.
Imagínense, Dios entregó a lo que más amaba.
Wow.
Para salvarte. Como leíamos en el versículo, porque de tal manera amó Dios al mundo que ha dado a su Hijo unigénito para que todo aquel que en él crea no se pierda, no tenga vida eterna.
In this precious verse, like my sister just stated, this is how much God loved Jesus more than anything, you guys, his only son. He gave up Jesus for you and for me.
¿Cuánto sufrió Jesús para que nosotros ahora pudiésemos tener entrada al reino de los cielos? ¿Cuánto sufrió? Dice su palabra que fue despreciado y desechado entre los hombres, varón de dolores, experimentado en quebranto. Y como que escondimos de él el rostro, fue menospreciado, dice, y no le estimamos. Porque muchos rechazaron a Jesús, no creyeron que él era el Mesías enviado por Dios, no creyeron que él era el que iba a salvar a la humanidad. Pero ahora, nosotros que hemos escuchado su palabra, tenemos ese anhelo, ese deseo de conocerle más, ese deseo de servirle. Podemos ver en su palabra cuánto él sufrió por cada uno de nosotros. Por eso nosotros tenemos que estar firmes en él.
And so because of this beautiful love that she just described, and I'm going to say it in a nutshell, the amount of suffering and rejection and shame that he took on, not only did God just say, okay, you're dying. No, the way he died, the form and the manner of which he was crucified, whipped, etc. God revealed his love already to us. We should be fully convinced of his love.
Amen. Dice que ciertamente llevó a él nuestras enfermedades y sufrió nuestros dolores.
In Isaiah 53:4-5, you know, he lays it all out in the book of Isaiah 53:4-5, that he was suffered, he was bruised for our and beaten for our transgressions, for our iniquities, and by his stripes we are healed.
Imagínense, Jesús dice que todas nuestras enfermedades, ¿cuánto no nos hemos enfermado? Y Dios nos ha sanado por medio del nombre de Jesús, ¿verdad? Porque dice que Él llevó todas nuestras enfermedades, todos nuestros dolores.
And with the sin, the price of sin being paid, Jesus made a way now, not only for us to be forgiven of our transgressions and iniquities, but also the sickness that comes in, right, as a result of sin, because that's where it comes from. And we are healed. How many of us have ever been sick and not experienced that healing?
Dice, y nosotros le tuvimos por azotado, por herido de Dios y abatido. Mas él herido fue por nuestras rebeliones, molido por nuestros pecados. El castigo de nuestra paz fue sobre él. Y por su llaga fuimos nosotros curados.
Amen. Isaiah 53:4-5 says clearly what he went through, what he experienced, the beating, the stripes that he received for our healing, and the bruising and the punishment for our rebellion. He was beaten for our rebellion, our iniquities, and our sins.
Todo lo que tuvo que sufrir Jesús, dice que fue molido por nuestros pecados, para que hoy nosotros pudiésemos obtener paz.
And he was crushed, you guys, and bruised for our peace. The chastisement of our peace, right? It fell on him so that we could have that exchange could take place and we could receive his peace.
Dice, angustiado él y afligido no abrió su boca, como cordero fue llevado al matadero. Y como oveja delante de sus tranquiladores enmudeció y no abrió su boca.
And you know, it goes on to describe the suffering that he went through. He was led, you know, right like a sheep to the slaughter, she's saying in Isaiah as well. Yet he didn't open his mouth, right? He knew he had to go through this, and he kept quiet, and he was led like a sheep to slaughter, and he never backed out, he never turned around and said no, and he did it for you.
Imagínense todo lo que sufrió Jesús y aún él no abrió su boca por amor a nosotros.
And that's love.
So, Dios hubiese podido destruir a la humanidad por todo lo que le estaban haciendo a su hijo. Pero él no lo hizo por amor a cada uno de nosotros. Y Dios dice que muestra su amor por cada uno de nosotros, que aún siendo pecadores, Cristo murió por nosotros y él nos da entrada al reino de los cielos.
Por eso. That's why you guys, right now, every one of you guys should be jumping up and down and screaming. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. We need to ask God to give us a revelation of what he did for us. That's why we don't love him like we should. We don't understand the love of God. God could have just very well easily changed his mind. Like, you know what, you guys are a bunch of losers. I'm just going to zap you all by. No, he gave up his son for us.
Pero por eso... Les digo que estén firmes en Dios, nunca se aparten de él.
Aleluya. That's why, right? We are not going to, you know, fall away. We're not going to backslide. We're not going to do anything stupid. We're going to stay with Jesus. We're going to stay with the Lord.
Aunque llegue la tentación a tu vida de querer pecar, no le des lugar. Acuérdate del texto que dice, no deis lugar al diablo y huirá de vosotros.
Right.
Nada más que
Amen.
Se tienen que someter a Dios.
Right? Amen. And in James chapter 5, believe it's verse 6-8, James 5, what does it say? Therefore, submit ye to God first, then resist the devil, and he will run away from you and flee.
Siempre recuerda lo que Jesús hizo por ti, para que no le deis lugar al pecado.
And that's why this understanding and understanding of God's love for us, we're not going to give sin. What is she saying? Give sin no place. Don't open the door.
Nunca te olvides que Él es el todo, que Él para ti es el gran amor que te tiene.
And so, wait, remember, meditate on His love, right? Meditate how much God loves us. This love is never going to change, you guys. Never. And that's what she's saying. She loves Jesus with all her heart. Why? Because she understands and knows how much he loves her. She knows it. This is real.
Si no, mantente firme en Cristo Jesús.
Amen. Amen. We remain firm and we place our feet on the rock, right?
Amen.
And we're not going to fall. In Jesus' name.
¿Quiénes han aceptado, quién quiere aceptar a Jesús en su corazón o quiere reconciliar con Él esta tarde?
Aleluya. So right now, amen.
Aleluya. Dice,
aleluya.
Gracias, Señor. Cuando alguien se arrepiente de su pecado, hay fiesta en el reino de los cielos.
Aleluya.
Porque es un hijo de Dios más, un hijo de Dios más aleluya. Que Dios recibe. Aleluya, gloria a Dios. Vamos a
orar.
Señor Jesús, te doy gracias por este día que has salvado mi vida. Te entrego mi corazón. Te entrego todo. Escribe mi nombre en el libro de la vida. Y que pueda ser un verdadero hijo de Dios. Guíame en tu camino y que nunca me aparte de ti. Y guarda mis pasos, guarda mi vida y te entrego todo a ti. Gracias por morir por mí y por darme salvación y vida eterna. Señor mi Dios, dale más de ti, Señor Jesús, y que seas tu Padre protegiéndolo de todo mal, Padre Celestial. Guárdalos en tu camino, Padre Santo Poderoso, que nunca se aparte de ti, Señor Jesús.
En esta hora, Padre, te pido que seas tu Espíritu Santo dirigiéndolo, Padre, en todo lugar, Padre. Sana toda dolencia, todo dolor, Padre. Todo lo, aquello, Padre, que a él le cuesta, Padre, dejar, Señor Jesús, que seas tú, Padre, en su vida, oh Dios, trabajando con él, Padre. Y que sea tu voluntad en su vida, Señor Jesús. Gracias, bendito Dios, por el amor que tienes, Padre, para cada uno de los que están en este lugar, Padre. Y sé que tú lo guardarás, Padre, y le pondrás completa paz. En el nombre de Jesús de Nazaret. Amén.
Puro amor de Jesús.
Dios le bendiga. Felicidades. Congratulations. Amén. ¿Quién más? Now today. 12.
Aleluya. Vamos, voy a cantar un canto que habla del amor que Dios tiene para cada uno de nosotros, que dice que aún siendo pecadores, Dios nos ama. Cuando estamos en angustia, en dolor, Él nos ayuda a que sigamos adelante porque su amor nunca se agota. Atención a la letra, porque allí Dios te muestra su amor para cada uno de nosotros.
Aún siendo así, un pobre pecador, Dios me ama.
Dios te ama.
Siendo imperfecto, aún sin merecerlo, Dios me ama. Si Él se fuerte, si yo soy de pie, Dios me ama. Si estoy débil, si yo estoy caído, Él no me dejará jamás. Sin su amor, sin su perdón, no sé qué sería de mí. Dios me amó tanto que entregó a su Hijo para morir en mí. Dios me ama y su amor es tan grande e incondicional. Dios te ama y siempre está con sus brazos abiertos a mí.
Dios te ama.
Aún siendo así, un pobre pecador, Dios me ama. Siendo imperfecto, aún sin merecerlo, Dios me ama.
Dios me ama
siempre está con sus brazos abiertos a mí. Dios te ama y su amor es tan grande, incondicional. Dios te ama y siempre está con sus brazos abiertos a mí.
Aleluya.
El amor de Dios es más grande que cualquier cosa.
Para morir en mi lugar.
Amén. Que Dios les bendiga.
That's right. Amor es tan grande. Nos ama. Come on.
Sus brazos abiertos a mí y a ti.
Come on. Yay! Hallelujah. Come on now. Hallelujah.